We're Millencolin. Yeah! From Scandinavia, Sweden. And it's great to be here. Nice weather. It's our first time here. Thank you.
Thank you.
the way. Thank you. and the old start on. This one for the strike.
We do that without respect. The strawberries booth, so come and say hi to us at like 3:30 or something. Come and say hey. But, okay, this one's about drinking. I don't do it, it sucks, but I'm sure you all do.
Thank you. Mathias from Millencolin.
Yeah, they're from Sweden.
Okay.
My first question is, how's Warp Tour been for you guys so far?
It's been very good. The first few days were pretty weird, because it's a big thing, and it travels, so it took some time for it to run smoothly, but now it's good.
Do you play like festivals like this in Europe and Sweden?
Yeah, we have super big festivals in Europe. Roskilde Festival in Denmark. 120,000 people.
Whoa, a lot bigger than this.
Well, that's 5 days, you know, that's big as hell.
Cool.
But it's good, this one is good. It's after a few days you get into the mode, you know, that you can run with. That's good. So I feel totally happy about everything now.
Have the bands been cool and stuff with you guys?
Yeah, we know a lot of bands before we went here, because we toured with them in Europe.
That's cool. Alright, how do the crowd reactions differ from like Sweden and the US?
Yeah, you got the circle pit there.
The circle pit?
We don't have that in Sweden.
And like, how do they dance there?
It's more like
jumping around and stuff.
Yeah. Okay. But it's cool though. Like,
yeah. And, who are your main like influences like musically? Like
nowadays, when we started off, it was Operation Ivy.
Operation Ivy.
Nowadays, it's more every band I hear.
That's cool. It was like when you're starting out, was it like? Is that from like Shake Me type music, like that stuff? Like that's like an influence from Op Ivy. Cool. Okay. I noticed in your song Trendy Winds that you mentioned like Cruise and how you hate to like, deal with that shit, you know? And I just want to know, in the US, like I see it a lot of hardcore shows.
Yeah.
Like, just crews go to shows just to start fights.
Yeah, I know. And I hate that. And the thing I hate the most about people who, like some magazines, they have problems sometimes with like attitude problems, because they try to decide which bands are sellouts or not. And
yeah,
the sellout thing, that is so stupid, because Offspring, they have sold a lot of albums.
Yeah.
They're no sellouts, because they were just lucky or whatever. They were an MTV, but that's their choice. I think.
Yeah, I don't really believe in.
People should stop bugging other bands, because they have their own minds. You know.
Yeah.
We should decide what we want to do, but we don't want to do. We don't want to be on MTV and stuff like that. We do our own way, and they do it their way, so that's
how you. Yeah, I just wanted, like, this was with the question, too, like, do you see, like, other lot of, like, fights that start with crews in, like, Sweden? Like, at, like, hardcore shows and punk shows?
In Sweden, it's more, we don't have that honest, hardcore, scene in that sense of.
Do you have a bit, like, do you have, like, a big straight-edge scene with, like,
yeah,
you?
Totally super big in the north of Sweden. So I guess, they probably have more like a crew thing there, but it's more friendly.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, here it's like a lot of violence.
Yeah, I saw that. I guess when we played, I guess it was New York.
Yeah.
And they were in the pit. They were like, go like this.
Yeah. Well, there's a lot of, especially in Boston, like a lot of people from New York come in. Like, they call like the BBC, and they just go to shows and start fights.
And the bizarre thing is also like big guys standing around the pit and just.
And New York's kind of scary like that.
Yeah, I don't know. I couldn't believe that.
in the early 1990s, there seemed to be like a punk breakout in the U.S. with like Rancid and like Green Day and Offspring and all that. Do you think the emergence of the Swedish punk scene had anything to do with that?
Yeah, it had. You know, that's the reason why punk music got big in Sweden also. You know, those bands and
like no fun at all. Like it kind of sound. Well, their first time I thought it kind of sounded like Pennywise-ish. Yeah. I mean, not their first one. They're what's it called?
Out of Bounds?
No, not Out of Bounds. What is it called?
No Straight Angles.
Yeah. Kind of sound a lot like Pennywise.
They did. It's pretty. They recorded a new one now that I haven't heard yet, but it's I guess it's good. It's a good band.
That's cool. Yeah, I'm a big fan.
Alright.
I know a couple of you guys skate. Are you gonna like partake in any of skating here in the Warped Tour?
Yeah, I skate a lot, and of course skate here.
Let's go. Are you the one who's like a champion in on the team in Sweden or whatever?
Yeah, I years ago I skated a lot before we started playing music. But skateboarding changed into a stupid sport.
You think so?
Nah, it did, but it's getting back again, I think.
There's a lot of people that's like, kids who do it just to be cool and stuff. Some kids just do it like to be cool or whatever.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. And it went big and it was stupid, but now it's much better, you know.
It's cool. Alright, I noticed Nicholas seemed, I don't know if this, you can answer this or whatever, but Nicholas seems to have a lot of like cartoonish lyrics. They're really happy and stuff. Do you know where that comes from? Like, how did you get inspired to like write those kind of lyrics?
No, I don't really know. But on the new album, the lyrics are more not that happy anymore.
Yeah, I know. Like they're kind of like
darker or whatever. But it's
still really good.
To how he feels that day, you know, when he writes the lyrics. It's more it's a day thing. Sometimes you're inspired, get inspiration to write a lyric.
Okay, I know you guys are huge in Sweden, but what about the rest of Europe? Are you guys big throughout Europe and Asia?
We're bigger in Germany now than we are in Sweden.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I know a lot of punk bands from, like the United States are big there, in, like, Germany.
Yeah, they are. The strange thing in Europe is that there's no... The only, like, big punk bands in Sweden, they're all from Sweden.
Yeah.
They in Europe, I mean, they're all from Sweden. That's pretty weird.
Is 59 times the pain for Sweden?
Yeah, well, we're totally good friends with you
right here. Let's go, what's up? How's it going?
We're good friends. But it's weird though, because Germany is such a big country. You know?
What?
Germany is such a big country, but they don't have that many punk bands, so I don't know.
Really? Yeah, I don't know, like,
they have a lot of punk bands, but they never toured.
Do you ever think you'd be playing like a huge festival like this when you first started out?
No. First time. When we started out, we just wanted to write music. That's what we did. We wrote so many songs the first 2 years.
Like, how come you just made like an EP? Or
yeah, we made it on the first year. We recorded like 30 songs.
Oh, really?
Even more, I think.
Close.
Two demo tapes, 12 songs each.
Jeez.
So we did two EPs with six songs each. Then we did
Is that were those like 30 songs before Use Your Nose or?
No, we had like 24 songs before that. Oh. That never is released.
Do you have like the demos like around anywhere? Like
yeah, we have them at home.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'd like to like order like.
Yeah,
okay. Alright.
But they're not that good.
They're not that good.
Well,
I'd
like
to check them out.
I think they suck. I heard them so many times. They're old, but I guess I don't know how you feel about.
Why I like your old stuff a lot, so
exactly. So I guess we like it.
Okay, are there any rivalries in the Swedish punk scene? I know, like, I heard that No Fun at All was supposed to get signed to Epitaph.
Yeah, that was totally weird, everything.
Yeah. Brett heard you guys and, like, he wanted to sign you or
something. It was so bad for No Fun at All, because they, like, Brett the called Burning Hot up and said, I want to sign the No Fun at All guys, and they were stoked, you know.
Yeah.
And they went down, like, this. And the press, they said like a TV and the newspaper, No Fun at All signed to Epitaph. And then 2 days after, he called up and said, I heard the Millencolin CD, I want to have those guys instead.
That's great. You guys definitely have like your own sound. Well, I like No Fun at All a lot, but like, I'm saying like you guys definitely like have a nice sound, like a unique sound.
And then the thing was that then, we're super good friends, No Fun at All. We played hundreds of shows.
Yeah, I'd love to see them. Have they ever, they toured in California, didn't they?
Yeah, I guess they're going to tour here. then maybe next year.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's definitely like
a good, yeah, good life.
Cool. All right, yeah, that's all the questions I have. Thanks a lot.
Thank
you. And you guys are awesome. Good luck on your rest of the tour.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Yeah. Cool. Backstage at the Warped Tour, baby! I just interviewed Mathias from the Guards, a nice guy. Gave me a beverage, which is cool. Look at all the buses and shit. Look at all the people, buses. Yeah. Think of it all as busting on, so I'm gonna see.
For the suburbans who came from outside. It's a tough road home.
All right. I want to be stereotyped. I want to be classified.
So far.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah, I like it too.
The crowd's retarded.
What? Yeah, the crowd's a lot of fine women
there. They're moshing it up.
Honeys.
they're banging into each other.
Let's check out the scene here. We got some porto potties over there and some like Sunday shakes and stuff.
People were real smart and tore down the mist tent.
Oh really? Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Let's stay hot all day.
Yeah, now I don't have any sorts of refreshment other than fucking $3 bottles of water.
What's up, bro?
So, they got Listen Jake shirts that are like Slayer. Listen Jake has an entire album of just Slayer covers.
I thought it's like a 7-inch.
Yeah, it is.
What's up, Creeder? Mad Creeder in the house. Lagwagon's going on! Oh yeah!
Playing right now! You're late!
Okay, hold on. Because we're Lagwagon and we care, someone lost their car keys.
Me!
So come and look for me. I'm pretty hard to find.
Take your car. Door! Raise a bird!
Are they? It's on them.
Would it make you feel much better if it was you against the world? If you were an alien with the word conspiracy, would it hurt to live in comfort if you found someone to trust? If you knew that you were with us, if we shared a common smoke. That's cool.
Descendents for you guys. We'll be right back. So let's go move the car.
You're the fucking best, man!
Because I like dirt.
Yeah, dirt!
Have to go.
Woo! I gave it to
I'm It's for him because he knows it all.
He knows what's going on. This guy here. This song's called Mellow.